The Alexandra was built in 1905 by Rhodes Curry in its Amherst, Nova Scotia plant for Earl Grey, Governor General of Canada. The car has been described as the most elegant car ever built by the company. The interior was selected St. Jago mahogany, and the wooden exterior had Governor General's car on the letterboard. The car then served Prime Ministers Laurier, Borden, Meighan, and King. It ended its career on the rails as part of Canadian National's Discovery Train in 1979. The Alexandra was named in honor of Queen Alexandra, 1844 to 1925, consort of King Edward VII. She was born in Copenhagen, Denmark, and her father was later King Christian IX of Denmark. She was devoted to her children and her servants and enjoyed activities such as dancing and ice skating. A strikingly attractive woman, Alex's high necklines started a fashion craze. Sir Albert Henry George Grey, 1851 to 1917, the fourth Earl Grey, was sworn in as Governor General of Canada at Halifax on the 10th of December 1904 and rode to his residence in Ottawa on the Intercolonial Railway. Earl Grey travelled throughout Canada extensively and was a strong promoter of national unity and of the arts. He established the Grey Competition for Music and Drama, which was first held in 1907. Today, professional football teams still compete for the Grey Cup, which he donated to the Canadian Football League in 1909. Lady Grey sponsored contests for beautiful gardens in Ottawa, known as the Lady Grey Competition, and also planted daffodils on the West Lawn, which visitors to Rideau Hall can still see today. After its use on the Canadian National's Discovery Train, the Alexandra was donated to the National Museum of Science and Technology in Ottawa. From there, it went to the town of Amherst, where it was displayed in the railway station yard, very close to where it was built. Later, the car was used as the town's welcome bureau on Highway 6 at Fort Lawrence, close to the site of the former Chignecto Marine Transport Railway. In 2006, the town of Amherst decided that the Alexandra was surplus to its needs, and it was purchased by the Nova Scotia Railway Heritage Society for preservation and was moved from Amherst to Tatamogouche.
So good, I realign on fly. course. That's lots of fun.
We're doing the money, right?
Thank you. Yeah, makes a good mic on quick there. Thank you.
heard rumbling out of the marsh there. It's coming. So.
You moving? Again?
Yeah, he's starting to get her lined up now. I guess he had to do it. Takes a while to get the dollies. So Justin's at a turn on it. And it'll take him a bit to get it straightened again. I think from now on it's going to be a pretty quick run, so better make sure we go with the better. I don't know where Bill is. There he is. And then move over there too. You hear the Fredo and the marsh there?
No.
It's coming. I don't know. Maybe. Sneak shot with the police car in the foreground. It takes a while to get the dollies re-straightened after this. Are they lowering it? Is that the... What is that noise?
They've got... what do they say? They've got hydraulics, right?
It looks like it's ready to go. And there goes the railway crossing. I just heard it trigger.
I guess we can afford to let the police car go, and then go, right? Running behind.
Okay, copy that.
guys will be glad to shoot tonight. Do you have any trouble along the way, or is she pretty straightforward?
That's right. Thank you.
wondered why it was going where it was going, because I knew where the rail car, the dining car was, because we were moving it down. So the two were going to sort of fit together.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, so there'll be a reception area from the far end and then the dining car.
Set it down, and it's just sort of locked in there.